Hello everyone, welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. This is just a quick one. I've made an update to a package that I pushed to Nugget.org, and that is Netcode-Hub.packages.component.validations. This package allows you to validate an edit form progressively. So whilst you type, it does the update. So here I've added a new feature to it, and that is this time around, you can specify the type. Let's have a look on how to do that. So I have a Blazor application or project created, as you can see. Now quickly, we're going to install this, right click on dependencies and manage Nugget packages. You can install this package to any of the Blazor model. Okay, so whether you're using interactive server, WebAssembly, interactive WebAssembly or any, you can still use it. So click on the browse tab and now let's install, type in Netcode Hub. You're going to see all the packages which have been pushed to GitHub. Yes, did I say GitHub? Nugget.org. So we're going to work on this Netcode-Hub.packages.component.validations. So this is what you see. The old version was 1.0 and now we have 1.0.1. So let's install this package. It's very simple. Two steps involved. Insert a package and I use a component. Very simple. Okay, so this is installed. Now we can close this. To verify this, we can just check from the dependencies packages, and you're gonna see it in here, 1.0.1. Okay, let's go to the component where you're gonna use this. Maybe in the pages, we have the home page. We need to include the package reference. So let's say at using, and it's gonna be Netcode Hub. So this is a way to use this floating component. Okay, in floating component, you have the floating number, you have floating text, and you have floating text area. Okay, so now with these three components, you can use a number if you want to actually set up only the numbers, you can use that. When it comes to the floating text, you know, we can also specify types in it. Now the type, this, we assign it to a text. We assign this to email. You can assign this to password. All they are all floating text, but you can change the type of these components. And now we have floating text area. What you should do here is you see we have our bind value property in here. And I want to check the we have our validation summary. We have our validation or data annotation validator also as well. You can decide to skip this since it's going to be displayed beneath each line. So we can just comment this. And now when it comes here, you can see we have an instance of the customer created, and there is a class. So in the class, we provided our property or attribute on top, and you can see these are required, and that is a range. We have a minimum and a maximum length. We have the same thing against the email, you see. And now here we are saying that this is email address. So these are custom, these are just an attribute that you can actually add, and they are coming from the system.componentModel.dataAnnotations. Okay. So this is what we have, and now that's a password. So the minimum length is 5, maximum is 10. Okay, so let's save this and see. So this is going to validate this form once you type. That's a progressive way. And let's see. Aside from this, if you want to actually get rid of the floating, we can also specify, we can also use another component known as a test, test area and the number. Let's first check this out. So this is ready. Now, if I type in any number, you see I have the displayed here. These are the errors that I have. Let's see, if I type in 5, the error is gone. 500, the error has what popped up. So you see it validated once I type, and it's floating area. So you see from the thread name, if I type, you see it must be 5 or more. You see that? And I'll check the email. As soon as I type this, it tells you that this is not a valid email. But let's say as soon as I add at, maybe m.com, you see it is off. So, and check the password. You see, it's also working, and you now have this test area. So you see, we have to have the floating component. What if you don't want this floating component? What can you do? You can also use this one. You can see from here that you yourself have to provide your label. Then what you need to do here is use this number, you see? Then when it comes to the name, we use this test component, and now the test component, you can specify the type in here as test. When it comes to this email, specify the type as email, And now when it comes to maybe the password, you can also specify the type as password. So let's copy. Let's also test this up. Yes, and now this form too is ready. So the same thing applies to what we did here. You need to specify your own label, but when you use the floating, the label has been added. What you need to do here is specify the label property, and that is all. But they are the same, so we see we can also do same in here, and that is it. Okay, so that's a way to use that. Feel free and now integrate this in your application. Thank you so much, and I'll catch you up again.